celebrating the Mass of Thanksgiving, the Mass of St. Lawrence, thanking God for this 100 years for this particular beautiful church building. As you know, this is, I think, the third building of St. Lawrence, and the church prior to this on Walnut Street in 1911 ran into difficulties because of the Capitol Park expansion. And at that time, a number of buildings, including St. Lawrence Church, were to be razed. And according to an article in the then the Patriot newspaper here, Bishop John Shanahan was in favor of suppressing St. Lawrence, according to the newspaper. But I think it must have been the dedication of the priest and the parishioners, many of whom the lineage were of German Catholics, who wanted to preserve this church. And this property then on State Street was purchased for the St. Lawrence Church. And my understanding is that on April the 19th in 1918, Bishop McDevitt inserted the relics of St. Lawrence and St. Benedict in the high altar, inserted other martyrs' relics in the side altars, and then the next day, April the 20th, 1918, solemnly consecrated St. Lawrence Church. So we're in the same month, very close to that April 20th day that you and I gather this evening in praise of our God and in thanksgiving for this great gift that St. Lawrence Church has been throughout more than 100 years for the downtown community and for the Diocese of Harrisburg since 1868. Our founding, we celebrate, as you know, in the Diocese this year, our 150th anniversary of founding. I can't help but think of the words of St. Paul in our first reading today, that those who sow abundantly reap abundantly. Paul, of course, was speaking about the witness and the lives of the early Christians to whom he was writing, but I think of our ancestors in the faith here, who, with great sacrifice, great trust in God, great commitment to their families and to the Catholic Church, sacrificed to build this magnificent church. And they sowed abundantly. And we, generations later, are reaping the abundance of their sacrifices, their love for God, their love for their Catholic faith, their love for the church. Paul's words in that first reading in his epistle come to life for us on this special 100th anniversary of the consecration of St. Lawrence's Church. Let us thank God together in this solemn pontifical Mass this evening for all the benefits that have been placed in our hands because of the generations of faithful Catholics before us. And let us pray that God and God's Holy Spirit will inspire us and give us every gift that we need to remain a vibrant community of faith and to continue to